set in the Hollywood Hills, and it was one of the most played in the game because of how great it flowed in just about every single game mode. Domination, Hardpoint, S&D, you name it, Raid had you covered. Call of Duty loves to reuse maps, and that's not necessarily a bad thing. They love bringing maps back and keeping the fans happy, and if the fans are happy, everybody's happy, right? But have you ever wondered which maps have gotten the most love from the developers? Which maps got spammed? At what point does a map become overplayed? What is up, everybody? Chaos here. Today, we are going to find that out. We are going to be checking out the 10 most reoccurring or spammed maps in COD history. These are those maps that have appeared the most times in Call of Duty history, either in a remake or a remastered form. You let me know which of these is your favorite, which ones you think need to be put in the vault and never brought back. Drop a like, make sure you have those notifications turned completely on, and let's kick things off with Terminal. Four appearances. That's right. That's what we're going to start things off with, everybody's favorite airport. Terminal made its debut in Modern Warfare 2. It was one of the most popular maps in the game. It was based off the extremely controversial No Russian mission from the campaign. It was a medium-sized, very fast-paced map, and it had a ton of verticality and power positions to keep things interesting during the game. It is one of the few maps in COD history that played excellently in every single game mode, and it's no shocker that it's become a fan favorite. It returned in Modern Warfare 3, COD Online, and Infinite Warfare. It gave it a total of four appearances if you don't count Warzone. I mean, I'm willing to bet it'll be five soon. I think we know it's inevitably going to be coming to Modern Warfare 2019 multiplayer eventually. But yeah, at number nine, Dome with four appearances. Another fan favorite Infinity Ward map. Dome first appeared in Modern Warfare 3 after it confusingly stole its name from a different small map in World at War. Now, MW3 Dome was the smallest 6v6 map in the game, and it was the go-to place for salty 1v1s and headshots-only trolling videos from Minnesota Burns. Dome was beloved. I mean, it was fast-paced, domination matches were absolutely nuts here, and it returned in COD Online, mostly unchanged. But then it was remade as Unearthed in Call of Duty Ghost. You guys remember the Venom X, the gun in that, the secret gun? And then it was slightly reimagined as Genesis in Infinite Warfare. Now, some people say Genesis was a reimagining of Strike Zone, but when you look at the layouts from the top perspective, it is pretty plain to see that Genesis is a monetization of Dome. But I'll let you guys hash that one out in the comments. At number eight, Raid. Five appearances. Black Ops 2 had some absolute banger maps, and Raid was one of the main standouts. Medium-sized map set in the Hollywood Hills, and it was one of the most played in the game because of how great it flowed in just about every single game mode. Domination, Hardpoint, S&D, you name it, Raid had you covered. And following its huge success in Black Ops 2, Raid returned in COD Online. Then it was remade as Empire in Black Ops 3. Then it popped up in the Blackout map of Black Ops 4, and then it got remade in its entirety in COD Mobile, making a grand total of five appearances for Raid. And speaking of it, have you guys heard of Raid Shadow Legends? No, I'm not gonna do it to you. At number seven, Crash. Five appearances. Let's stick with the number five. Yeah, 555. Debuting in COD 4, it was one of the best maps IW has ever created, if you ask me. The square footage was pretty medium-sized for the map, but it felt a lot bigger because of the abundance of verticality. There were a ton of buildings for you to go into, a bunch of little nooks and crannies to explore, plenty of flanking routes, and a lot of high ground. But despite all this space to move around, the map was still very fast-paced and not too campy, well, excluding Modern Warfare 2019. After its first appearance in COD 4, it was brought back as DLC in Modern Warfare 2, then Modern Warfare Remastered, then COD Mobile, and then Modern Warfare 2019 with some slight alterations. And personally, I think the MW2 version is the best. It was the exact same as the COD 4 version, but all the gameplay additions of Modern Warfare 2, which made it play a lot better. At number six, with 5.5 appearances, you heard me right, Rust. One of the most iconic maps in COD history, but its appearances, they're a little weird. Now, it debuted in Modern Warfare 2 as the 1v1 map of choice, and for ridiculously high kill gameplays and max prestige boosting lobbies, or master prestige, whatever it was back then. And it was based on the final mission of Modern Warfare 2's campaign where you face off against General Shepard. Rust gave birth to an entire subculture of gaming with Rust Intervention 1v1s, and to this day, if you go back to Modern Warfare 2, it will not be long before someone challenges you to a 1v1 quickscope duel right there. It returned in COD Online and COD Mobile, mostly unchanged. Then it was reimagined in Infinite Warfare as Excess. And then it was brought to Modern Warfare 2019 in its original glory. But the reason I put the 0.5 in the number is because Rust also appeared in Advanced Warfare, but it's inaccessible without hacking in the game. On the AW map compound, Rust is completely remade out of bounds. And to this day, it's unclear if this was supposed to be an Easter egg or if Rust was actually supposed to appear in AW, but it was cut during development so they just threw it in the background. But Rust isn't the only map with some goofy stuff like this. At number 5, Karantan. 5.5 appearances, another map that has appeared many times throughout COD history, but also has its own bizarre out-of-bounds appearance. Karantan first appeared in COD 1, and it was one of the main multiplayer maps in rotation. It was then brought back in COD 2, then remade as Chinatown in COD 4, then Chinatown returned in Modern Warfare Remastered as DLC, and then Karantan returned to its original form in COD World War 2. However, it also has a weird out-of-bounds appearance in Black Ops 3, which is why I'm giving it 5.5 appearances. The BO3 map Infection takes place in this weird simulation of the World War II Battle of Bastogne. However, if you look up to the south side of the map, you'll see a fully modeled town that you can't get to, and that town is actually a remake of Karantan, hidden in plain sight. So because it made it a little unplayable guest appearance there, I give it a 5.5. At number 4, Summit. 6 appearances. One of Treyarch's most spanned maps. Summit was one of the big standouts from the original Black Ops and has since become one of COD's most iconic maps. It was set on a snowy mountain base in the USSR, and it was known for its tight corridors and insane battles in the main center room, as well as the fights for control over the second floor windows. Now, killstreaks were a little weird here. They were. Much of the map has a roof over it. That also meant when someone called in a chopper gun or a gunship, everybody would flood to the center building for cover, at which point it would be an all-out brawl, and it was fun. Summit was remade as Uplink in Black Ops 2, then it was brought back to its original form as Summit in COD Online, then it was made DLC for Black Ops 3, then it was a launch map in Black Ops 4, and it returned once again in COD Mobile for its 6th appearance. At number 3, Nuketown. 6 appearances. I bet you thought it was going to be number 1. Well, you were wrong. It debuted in Black Ops 1, and there's no way Treyarch knew that it had this much of a hit on their hands with it. It was the smallest map in the game, and by far the fastest pace, leading it to becoming one of the most iconic maps in COD history. Nuketown helped shape the foundation of modern Call of Duty map design by creating an arena that was super small, very fast-paced, but still big and dynamic enough for you to get your bearings together before jumping back in the fight. Nuketown returned in Black Ops 2 as Nuketown 2025, Black Ops 3 is Nuketown, Black Ops 4 is just Nuketown with a snowy makeover, and it's also had appearances in COD Online and COD Mobile, which gives it a total of 6 appearances. But there is one map in COD history that has shown up in more than 6 games. Actually, well, there's 2 maps. One of those 2 maps is Firing Range. Treyarch had some good maps, man. 6.5 appearances, another one of Treyarch's babies. One of the main fight maps in the original Black Ops and was by far one of the most well-played. Very small, fast-paced, extremely action-packed, and this map had everything you could ask for from a COD map. Plus, because there were so many aerial streaks in Black Ops 1 and there wasn't a whole lot of cover, if you got a chopper gunner on Firing Range, well, that was a big fat GG. Firing Range was made a studio in Black Ops 2, then brought back in COD Online, then DLC for Black Ops 3, launch map for Black Ops 4, and another remake in COD Mobile. I'm going to give it the 0.5 here because it also appeared in Black Ops Declassified as Range. But that version was kind of chopped up and it was only a portion of the map. So I don't think it really should really count as a full entry. So we're going to give it a 6.5 and call it a day. And at number 1, with a whopping 7 appearances, Shipment. I was shocked. It's the single most spam map in COD history, and I think it's pretty easy to see why. It's small, it's hectic, it's easy to remake, and it's always a fan favorite because of how much people love getting high kill games and quick progress on their camo challenges. It debuted in COD 4, and in terms of square footage, it's still the smallest 6v6 map in COD history. I mean, it's fast-paced, you know, the flow's crazy with this thing. Then it returned in COD Online with a few changes. Then it returned in Black Ops Declassified as Container. Then Call of Duty Ghost as Showtime. Then Modern Warfare Remastered as Shipment. Then COD World War II as Shipment 1944. And then in Modern Warfare 2019, reimagined again as the new Shipment. 7 appearances. And I guarantee you we haven't seen the last of it. It was also remade in Modern Warfare 2, but it was cut during development, so I'm not going to count that one. But if you manage to get your hands on an alpha copy of Modern Warfare 2, which I don't know anybody that's going to be able to do that, testing suggests that it was there. Shipment is definitely a polarizing map in the COD community because a ton of people hate it for how hectic it is, but everybody always asks for it as well. Now, the remakes never seem to be able to get the spawns right, but it is what it is. Shipment, 7 appearances, takes the top of our list today. If you guys enjoyed, drop a like, and I'll see you soon.